Yeah, Thanks 803, or the UK thing is actually a subscription, and Rob tried to sign up for that, but because we didn't think about it until like last night, it says it could take up to 36 hours to take effect. So unfortunately, Rob wasn't even really sure he was gonna try. He was kind of joking about it, but then he started getting encouragement from all of us, and unfortunately the timing just didn't work out. But maybe on a future podcast, even though it won't be a Kate episode, we can get Rob to call in and you can all get a
Yeah.
chance to hear him.
Yeah, it's gonna be great. Hopefully some other time he can call in and we'll be able to hear his awesome accent.
I know.
Yay. So, and I
Yeah,
wanna
so I hope you all can hear it because I've heard it many times and I never get tired of his accent. So if I don't get tired of it, you guys will all love it. I know. Found it.
You have a
Oh,
call.
hold on. Hello? Rob?
Hello?
Rob!
Hello?
Hi.
Hi,
Oh my
Rob.
God.
I can hear you.
Yay!
Yeah, I'm really wound up.
I know. Do your best.
I can't say swear words, can I? No.
No.
You'll be
No,
fine.
but
Thank you for calling in. That's so exciting. Yay.
fantastic. All right.
Yay. Okay, so we haven't read out your mirror moments yet. Do you want to do your mirror moments? And then if you have time, tell us a little bit about.
No, can you do them?
Yeah?
No,
I don't even
Rob.
know what I can't even remember what I was gonna say now.
That's
It's
okay. You were gonna read out that one mirror moment that I don't want to
really messed my
read.
brain. It's really messed my brain up trying to get in.
I know. But you're on the call now. At least say hello to everybody.
I don't want to be on for long because how much this
I
is
know.
costing me, be honest.
I know. But everybody in the chat's really happy to have you on the call.
We've
everyone's saying hello to you.
got a
Pardon?
lot of yays and exciting going on.
Yeah. Everybody's really happy that you're on the call.
Well, if I can compose myself and remember what I was going to say, then
You want me to start out reading your mirror moments and then you can interrupt me when you're
I
ready
don't want to
to.
be on for long, that's the thing.
Okay. You want to tell everybody how you started watching Lost?
I turned the TV on and it was on.
Oh.
Did you start watching at season one at the beginning?
Right from the start, yeah.
Really? So did you catch the
I
pilot when
mean,
it
when
was?
I saw it in, we got this thing magazine over here called Radio Times, and I saw a big article about it, and I thought, well, I'll give this a go, but it looks like it's going to be the love lives of beautiful people. I thought, one of those kind of things, I thought, I'm not going to get into this. But as soon as I saw a sci-fi element come in, I think it's the same as a lot of people, I was hooked on it.
Oh, that's
Yeah.
great.
I mean,
That's great.
I saw the smoke monster, but this is unusual. It's not what I expected at all, so same as everyone else, really. I got hooked from the
Yeah.
start.
Yes, that's great. And then you watched it from then on. You saw all the episodes?
Yeah, I mean, it was difficult over here because it went from one of the main channels to Sky, and I didn't have
Which is a
Sky,
paid
so.
channel.
Sorry?
Sky is a paid channel. That's why it wasn't so easy for you to watch it on
So I
Sky.
had to kind of avoid anyone talking about it for months and buy the DVDs from then on. I think that was after season one or maybe season
Yeah.
two. They took it off channel four, put it on Sky One.
That's
So
cool.
yeah, I mean, it was out going for the months and having to tell people, don't tell me about it. I mean, Michelle will tell you when I first discovered her on Twitter, I said, don't tell me, Michelle, I'm going to have to get rid of you.
Yeah. Yeah, we met on Twitter in 2009, actually August 15th, 2009. And so I had already seen season five, and I already knew what was going on with Daniel Faraday and John Locke, but Rob didn't. And I had to keep my mouth zipped because we were both such huge fans of Lost, and we couldn't talk about it until after the DVDs came out in England.
Oh, wow. Well, real quick, we've got a really cool mirror moment, Rob, that Mark pointed out. You were just talking about Sky One, and you are number one on the chat, the call-in. You just show up as number one.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
So
you're number
that's
one.
cool. Rob is number one.
Rob
Yay.
is number
I
one.
tried to call him before, and that happened, the number one.
Yeah.
That's great.
Awesome, Rob.
Cool. Oh.
Do you want to tell us your mirror moment that I won't read out?
Yeah, go ahead. The one about recruiting.
Hold on a second, Ms. Wright. Hold on a second, Ms. Wright.
I might have to get it up. I can't remember. I'm going to have to try and find it.
I can prompt you. I have it.
I know it, too.
Yeah.
I typed out and now I can't find it.
About Ilana. Funny. About Ilana.
Oh, I thought it was about Man in Black.
Well, it's Ilana says something about the Man in Black.
Yeah.
I want to read it out as I got it typed down. But
yeah.
I can't find it.
Like I said, everybody, when I read out your mirror moments, Rob spends a lot of time on his mirror moments.
I am really wound up with trying to get in.
I know. But you sound really good.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sounding good to myself.
Well, everyone loves it, so like
you
I told
sound,
you they would.
You sound good to us.
Yeah.
It's fun. So,
I think I've got to get the emails up.
That's yeah. Okay. I want to say something really quick. I am so excited that you called in, Rob, because this can give more encouragement to Nellie and 803er to call in, because they never call in. And now we can say Rob is calling in all the way from England. So 803er and Nellie, y'all can call in, right?
I had lost weather guy last week, Chris, and I thought, you know, he's done it. I mean, I've really got to give it a go now.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right.
I mean, it's coming to the end of the season now. It's coming to the end of the podcast now, so I'm not sure running the podcast. I don't know what you're going to do after the season six, but I thought, you know, I'm going to have to call in sometime and do it.
Yes. I'm glad you did.
Bill Collins says you're rocking. You're rocking, Rob.
Yeah, I'm rocking with the stress, yeah.
Yeah, you sound great, though. You don't sound stressed at all.
Well, even let me into the I'm going to have to type this in. Sorry.
That's all right. And Nellie's in New Jersey. He can't make any more excuses that he can't call in.
But
if Rob can call from England, Nellie can call from New Jersey.
I didn't want to be in this long. You see, you don't know how much this is.
I know.
Mark said Phil called in before, so I know they have phones in New Jersey.
Right. Do
you want to do my other memos first? I really wanted to leave that one to the left.
Okay.
I know, but don't you have
to go?
If I can find it.
That's okay to do that one first, and then you can go so it won't cost you so much.
You want me to email it to you again so you can see it right away?
I don't think his email is up right now, is it?
Yeah, it's up, but I can't find it.
Do you want to? We can send it back to you.
Got it.
Okay.
Well, basically, it was for the substitute, and it was in this episode, Ilana says that the Man in Black is recruiting. Ms. Wright is regularly recruiting for co-hosts and for attendees to upcoming Austin Tweet Up.
Yes, I am.
She's recruiting.
I am recruiting people to come to the last Tweet Up, and MIB was recruiting also. Although I don't really know if I want to be compared to MIB, but that's okay. It was a very good mirror moment.
Yeah, he didn't mean it that way.
I know.
You're more like Jacob than the Man in Black.
Thank you very much. That's a good one. Thank you so much.
It's very good.
And I'm trying to get all these questions. There were some questions for me.
Oh, yeah, Ms. Wright had some questions for Rob.
Oh, yeah. Can I just ask them?
Can I just find them?
Do you mind if I just ask them? Or do you want to read them? Because I remember what they are.
What is my favorite Kate-centric episode?
Yes.
Any one that she's in a shower in, I think.
Seriously,
my mind doesn't work like that. I don't really go for single episodes. I take TV shows as a whole. Suppose if I really had a favourite, it wouldn't be a Kate-centric episode. It would probably be something like this, Together, Die Alone, because you really got the sci-fi element in that.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I mean, that's the first time you really saw the sci-fi element of that with the failing to press the button, and that's, for me, when it really got exciting at the end of season two. There were hints to the sci-fi element before, but that's really when it started taking off in the sci-fi way.
Yeah, you're right. That's good.
I mean, I have a lot of people say to me on Facebook is, oh, Lost. I don't get that. I always say to them, well, people who watch it regularly, we don't get it either. I say to them, I always show them that episode. I always get the video off YouTube and I show them this episode, the sci-fi element.
Yeah.
That's good. Really good.
That's good, Rob.
Well, great.
Is there anything else, Rob?
Did he know that what Kate does Mimo off the top of his head, or did he research and find all of them as he went? I think the only research, really, you haven't done them yet, so I can't really talk about them.
One of his mirror moments.
What you were saying to me earlier, Rob, was that these things just come off the top of your head. Rob's quite a genius on the radio station that's in his local city, and he is very good at finding connections from music to shows
I think we're talking about the Poison. Was it the Poison one?
Yes.
To say this without being like sounding egotistical is unknown locally. It's quite a muso. So really, Poison is one of those well-known songs. I don't know how big it was over there in the States, but it was massive over here. It was nearly number one.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think it made number one, but it was close. And it's one of those things that everyone knows, Poison, Alice Cooper. So no research needed at all for that.
Yeah.
One of them about the Bok group, Michelle will read out. There was a bit of research because it involves Emery Ian Cusick. And, of course, this was 2003. I didn't know him. I didn't even know him when he first appeared on Lost. Mm-hmm. So I wouldn't have known him pre-Lost.
Yeah.
So we have to do a bit of research about that. And that's about it, really.
Yeah. Well, good job, Rob. Do you have to get going?
I'm not going to be able to stay on for too long now.
That's all right. Well, thank you so much, Rob, for calling in.
I would have been better than this, but I'm really wound up with trying to get in. I had to turn off the mic.
You sound great.
We'll have to try back another time, maybe. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thanks, Ms. Wright.
Thank you, Rob.
Okay,
okay, talk to you later on the chat.
Okay, we'll see you back in the chat, okay?
Okay, bye.
Bye.
Okay, bye.
That's awesome. Yay. That's so cool. I think that's our second international call. We had a guy call in from Australia.
That's right.
But I think that Rob's the second international call.
Actually, Lost Tattoo Guy was calling from Canada.
Oh, that's true. I don't think of Canada as...
Oh, my gosh. Okay, check this out. He's our fourth international call.
Okay, who else?
Okay, so our first one was our friend in Australia who had the baby named Eloise.
Yeah.
The second, Lost Tattoo Guy.
Yeah.
Third, Bethany Shady.
Oh, because she was in Canada also. Yeah.
She was in Canada because that's where they're filming Alcatraz.
Yes.
And fourth is Rob.
Yeah, cool. He's number four. I like Locke.
That's right. That's a number. That's right. Like John Locke.
Yeah, that's cool.
And you know,
it's
funny. When I first met Rob in 2009, he didn't know all the stuff about Man in Black and fake Locke. Because none of us knew until the end of season 5, right? Mm-hmm. We just thought Locke was still alive, and he's just got a lot more confidence. And so Locke is one of Rob's favorite characters. So there's another mirror moment to Rob.
Oh.
Ms. Wright, I'm sorry to interrupt you. Rob called back.
Oh, okay. Let him in.
I'm sorry, Rob?
Hello. I just wanted to call back and tell Ms. Wright that the phone bill will be in the post.
Oh.
Funny. Do you want to give your Kate rate real quick? Very well. You did that earlier.
I can't give the Kate rate.
Okay,
no, he can't.
Okay.
It's not meant for family podcasting.
Okay.
I really want to anything? The show wouldn't let me.
No, I vetoed it. Anything else, Rob?
No.
Well, thank you for calling back.
Yeah, no problem.
Okay.
Okay.
Bye, Rob.
Nice.
It's so silly.
Me cute.
Okay.
He's so cute.
Silly.
He is silly. I'm glad you all get a chance to hear him because, you know, obviously he's funny in the chat and on Twitter and everything, but, you know, then you hear that English accent and it's just like everything he says is cute, you know.
Yeah, that's cool.
Well, thank you, Ms. Wright, for being my co-host tonight and a very special thank you to Rob Lost Heart to Kate for calling in all the way from England. Thank you so much, Rob. Hopefully you can do that again really soon.
Yeah.